Hey guys, what's going on? It's Don here from Nova Spirit Tech, and I'm super excited to show you this new board called the Nano Pi Fire 3. It's a $35 octa-core board, so let's get started. Now the guys over at Friendly Arm decided to send me over this board for a review and to do some light mining. Now I'll leave all the links in the description below so you guys know what I'm talking about. To get started with the review, this board is actually using a Samsung S5P6818 chip with paired up with 1 gig of RAM. Now it still has the 40-pin header like you would find on a Raspberry Pi 3, but that's where all the similarity kind of ends. On one side you have the USB 2.0, the gigabit Ethernet, and also a micro HDMI. On the opposite side, you have two buttons, which is the power and the reset, and then you can hook up a display to that port. On the other side, you have the micro USB to power it, and also USB in, a camera interface, and also the micro SD card. Now, this guy does not have Wi-Fi. Being it's such a powerful board and a small board, I know Wi-Fi would really be great, but not to fear. This guy actually has a big brother version called the Nano Pi T3. It uses the same chipset, but double the amount of RAM with all the interface that you're looking for. Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, more USB ports, headphone jack. Now, I'm not really going to get into this guy as much. I'll make another video for it, but as far as I know, the Nano Pi 3, to keep it at the cost of $35 with this much horsepower, it's a sacrifice they had to make, I'm pretty sure. All right, to get into the nitty gritty part of this stuff, I've tested this board against a couple of mining algorithms. Now, one, which is XMR. Now, on their website, they show that they're getting about 30 hashes per second, which when I first started playing around with this, I was only able to get 28. I couldn't get to 30. So as soon as I disconnected the monitor, I was able to get to 30. So just food for thought. The monitor does slow down the hash rate. So if you're going to use this for mining, you might not want to hook up that monitor. So here are the numbers for XMR. They actually done most of the tests with their boards, which I don't have. So I'm going to put their list on. But it is much faster than a Raspberry Pi 3. And if I did have a working XU4 board, I would be able to pull those numbers as well. But as far as Googling, these numbers are very comparable to them. I did do a quick test with Magicoin, and this guy was able to get 18.77, which is double the speed of Raspberry Pi 3 on stock clock. Obviously, on the Raspberry Pi 3, if you overclock it, you could get about 11, close to 12. But yeah, on stock clock, 64-bit operating system, I was able to get 18.77, and the Raspberry Pi was 19 and change. The operating system this guy supports is Android, 64-bit Ubuntu, and a 32-bit Ubuntu that they actually keep updated on their website. So when I first started playing around with this board, I downloaded one image. A couple of days later, they already updated that same image to the later version. So they do keep on top of their images, unlike some other boards that I reviewed before. Now, the size of this guy is pretty small. It is almost half the size of a Raspberry Pi 3. The package does include its own heat sinks, and you must use a heat sink. This thing does get warm. As far as the power consumption on this guy, on idle, it's at 0.37 amps at 5 volts. And at full-blown power, mining, cores, everything, it's running at 0.84 amps on 5 volts. That's really low power consumption for this guy with this much horsepower. So guys, if you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button. If you guys got any questions about this or want me to test anything on this guy, hit up in the comments below. If you guys are new to this channel, consider subscribing and also hitting that bell notification icon so you know when the next video is going to be out. And as I say in my nerd cave, hack till it hurts.